In the early 50s, if it was Thursday night in Indiana, your set was turned to WTTV to see Uncle Bob Hardy and the Hayloft Frolic.
I had formed the Happy Valley Folks group in the 40s, and then began to do that on television. Then in 1952, after I left for a year, went to a radio station over in North Vernon, and I came back and I formed another show called the Hayloft Frolic. And that's where people know the music end of it more, from the Hayloft Frolic. And I had started such people, local people in it, as Joe Edwards, who's been staff guitarist at the Grand Ole Opry since 1955 now. And of course, another one of the young people that I started in the business was a fellow named Bobby Helms. Of course, we recorded My Special Angel and Fraulein and Jingle Bell Rock.
Jack Knoll would eventually take over hosting duties for the Happy Valley Folks.
With all the Happy Valley Folks, with all the carry-ins on by Cousin Jenny, Dilly and his fiddle, lovely Wilma Blair, Roy Coulter, Paul Kidwell, Don and Carolyn Linsicum, the guitar stylings of Dewey Harris, and a host of special guests. Here's the biggest cut-up of them all, Happy Jack Knoll.
Well, thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. Welcome again to our show. All the folks from Happy Valley are here, and today we've got a lot of guests to entertain for the next 30 minutes. We hope you'll find it very enjoyable. What do you say we start off with one of your favorites on the show? You tell us for your cards and your letters and all. Make her welcome tonight playing down yonder. Here she is at the piano, Carolyn Linsicum. Give her a high hand.
Frolic show that I started in 52. Chuck Haynes, who was here, we visited with Chuck, a tremendous, wonderful artist. I gave him an idea. I said, I want the inside of a barn. That's what I want, and the scenery. And he had a certain number of flats that we would do it on. He used brown rolled wrapping paper, like you would have big rolls of wrapping paper, and with black, painted that scene. When you put it on camera, it looked like it was 10 miles down through that. The perspective he had on it was fantastic. Now, the amazing thing was that we fastened that green wrapping paper up on the flats with staple gun. Staples. I'm not staple gun, that's staples. Mm-hmm. Staples. Then when the show was over, we had to go around with a staple puller and take all that off and roll it up and put it in a bin, because next week we had to unroll it and staple it up again. We couldn't, of course, they had to use the flats for other things. We could not have flats of our own. We had to share. And we used that same wrapping paper for almost 4 years, every Thursday night.
Right now, we wish you to make welcome a young man who's been a part of our show for many years. Give him a nice hand, Roy Coulter. Roy, boy. Come on out here, son. Man, you're all dolled up there, ready to go. They must be going to put you in the movie.
I believe they are. With a new haircut and all, they might just do that. Can't they?
That's the doggonest haircut I ever seen.
Stand it.
Let's try that number and see what happens.
They're going to put me in the movie. They're going to make a big star out of me. We're going to make a film about a man who's sad and lonely. All I gotta do is act naturally. I'll bet you that I'm gonna see a big star. Life win and lost, you can't never tell. The moon is gonna make me a big star, 'cause I can play the part so well. Well, I hope you come and see me in the movie. Then I know that you will plainly see the biggest fool that ever hit the big time. All I gotta do is act naturally. We're gonna make a film about a man who's sad and lonely, and he's begging on his bended knee. I'll do the part, but I won't need rehearsing. All I gotta do is act naturally. I'll fix you that I'm gonna be a big star. What women off here, you can't never tell. The movie's gonna make me a big star, 'cause I can play the part so well. Well, I hope you come to see me in the movie. Then I know that you will plainly see the biggest fool that ever hit the big time. All I gotta do is act naturally. All I gotta do is act naturally.
Very much, boy, very fine.
The thing I'd like to see will never happen is that I think the spontaneity and the creativity of something live is just beyond measure. You can't have it nowadays because they don't want to gamble. There's too much risk. You can put stuff together like piecework. It's like you're producing this show. You're not sitting down and doing this whole show from start to finish, starting at 4 o'clock and ending at 5 or 5:30. You're putting together, putting pieces. And it takes creativity. I'm not putting it down. But you have to put the puzzle together. You have to paint the picture with pieces. We had to paint the picture live. See? Joe Edwards playing guitar one time, the fellow's down at the Grand Ole Opry now. The senior fellow back of him during his number. The director was sharp enough and quick enough that he cut to a camera, tight shot of Joe's hand playing the guitar. Crew came in, righted the scenery, set everything up. People never saw it. People never saw the flat fall.
Mr. Dillingham,
yeah.
We're supposed to walk right over this way here.
All right.
And we've just done so now.
How are you getting along with all this music?
Well, pretty good.
Really?
Just minus heaven when. There's an old tune, Dilly, that we do wherever we go. We do it on the road. We do it when we get together.
That's one thing.
That's about boiling down some cabbage,
yeah,
and turnip greens or something or other.
All
you boys get a chord and let's go together. What do you say?
That's a good one.
I'm glad for one time the cameraman didn't take a picture of those big old clodhoppers. You.
I got them wound up.
You have? What's new?
I got I got a letter from home. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Is that Grandpa? He's getting so lazy.
Really?
He is, that old fella. He just...
He must be now 100 now, ain't he?
Yeah, he is. Maybe a little bit over.
Did he say the grace this year again?
Yeah. Every Thanksgiving, Paul lets him say the grace.
That is a fine.
Usually, he just says it kind of a whisper, you know. Everybody bows his head. He bows his head, too. And this year, he just got plumb carried away, they tell me.
Oh, is that
right? Just hollered grace out, practically.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Really got carried away.
Well, that's what angels do for you, I suppose.
I like that, but you know what happened? When he bowed his head down, he grudged me.
Oh, now look, yeah. Now look.
That's why I got to tell you. You know, he's getting lazy. That old feller won't even make a pot of coffee anymore.
No?
He won't do it. He sprinkles a little bit of coffee on his mustache and drinks hot water.
Oh, now. Here are the driver's sisters. Welcome to the